afternoon, and welcome back. It's been a hectic week, so today we're going to do something real quick, nothing too intricate and long. I actually found out recently that Pinterest has tutorials. They're not like super intricate, but they do a fairly good job from what I've seen, and I actually tried one the other day, and it turned out fairly well. So I was like, okay, that might be kind of a fun thing to do, is follow a Pinterest tutorial. The one that I found for today is a purple eye look using the Too Faced Chocolate Bar, which is this one here, one of my, OG faves. But yeah, just something real quick and short, so we're gonna go ahead and get started. So this is a tutorial I found. I'm going to show it up here, but I'm also going to pull it up on the screen so you guys can see it a little bit better. And I'm going to follow that to do my makeup today, to do the eye look today. I'm going to go ahead and start with my CoverGirl Lid Lock Eyeshadow Primer. Super low on this. I'm glad I've got another one floating around here. Of a different kind. So it looks like the first color that they use is Salted Caramel, which is this one right here. So I'm going to get some kind of loose. Let's see. I'm going to use this angled brush. It doesn't have too much gross stuff in it. Yeah, this is okay. This Luxie medium angled shading brush, and I'm going to grab Salted Caramel and put that in the crease, which is what it says to do to start. I'm also going to grab my Crown Blending Brush and kind of soften some of the edges up here. Step two. Alright, it looks like for step two is the outer corner, and they're using Semi Sweet, which is this right here. I'm gonna go ahead and use this same brush, maybe. I'm gonna go ahead and use this same brush, dip it into Semi Sweet, and then kind of put it in this outer corner. This is not the look that I'm hoping. I was hoping for it too, so I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side and then build up the color a little bit with a different brush. I'm going to grab this one from Crown, this flat brush, and I'm gonna go ahead and go back into Semi Sweet and kind of pull that into some of the, pull a little bit more of that into the crease, into the outer third. There we go, just deepen it up a little. I'm gonna go back in with my blending brush and kind of blend that into the crease a little bit and blend out those little edges there. I'm gonna go back into Semi Sweet and kind of darken it up a little bit more. Alright, what's step three? Looks like step three is going to be the purple, which goes all down the middle of the lid. I'm going to use... This looks like it's already got purple on it. This is a flat brush that I got from Wet n Wild. It looks like it's got purple on this side already, so I'm going to go ahead and dip into Candied Violet, which is this shade right here, and put that all over the center of the on me. This purple looks really dark. Never understood why. Let's try with a finger instead of that brush. It definitely helps with the pigment. It doesn't really help with the issues I'm having with the color. Actually, that is a little better. I think there's another eyeshadow mixing with that on the other side, because it looks a lot better over here where I didn't use the brush. looks like the next step was... It looks like they went in with white chocolate, which is this shade right here up on the brow bone. Let me find something fluffy. Doesn't have a lot of color on it. Clearly I need to wash my brushes because basically all of them look ridiculous. There's this little one from Luxie and kind of blend that in. Problem with shadows like this is that I'm so pale, they just don't make a difference as a little brow bone highlight. Can't even tell. It's bad. And then, let's see. Next is, I'm going to take this same brush and go in with Champagne Truffle, which is the shimmery pink shade here, and go in the inner, like, third or so of my lid. Kind of blend it into that purple. Brighten that up a little bit. And bring it around so that it's kind of part of my inner corner. I'm going to take my blending brush again, blend those two together, and also blend everything into the crease. And the final step is on the lower lash line, taking the shade Triple Fudge, which is this here. And I'm going to use this little angled brush. This shade's so dark, it's not going to be an issue. And I'm going to just dust it really close to my lashes, kind of like an eyeliner on my lower lash line. I'm going to dot a little bit in the outer corner as well. Kind of shadow it all out a little bit. So this is technically the finished look, based on the tutorial, and this is what I was supposed to be getting. I think it's close. I think it's not quite what I would want. Obviously, if I was going to wear this out, I would, of course, do my whole full face, some black liner, probably black liner all the way around. Mascara, a wing, which both, all of those things would really help kind of tidy this whole thing up. But I'm really not loving that purple lid shade. It's really dark on me and it looks really muddy. I don't know if it's just the fact that I got a bad batch or if it's how old this is or if I managed to contaminate the original shade with other colors. All of those things are, in fact, highly likely. Because that was one of my most well-used shades for a while there. So if I was wearing this out, what I would probably do is pull out my Morphe 35P and kind of tidy up the pink or the purple a little bit, lighten it up. If you don't have access to the 35P, what I would do is I would take Marzipan, the shade here, and kind of take it on a finger and then put it, like pop it kind of in the middle and then blend it out. See how that works. Yeah, it lightened it up a little bit. Which is really what we're after. We're not trying to add a different color, we're just trying to lighten that purple up a bit. Makes it look a little bit more lilac-y. The problem is that it's still very muddy. So, I don't know if I'd entirely call this a fail because I would wear it out, but it's definitely not looking the way it's supposed to. So, we're gonna go with maybe on this. I think the muddiness could also be partially due to the fact that my brushes aren't perfectly clean. I know that can make a difference in how muddy your look is, so I would give it a try. I will post a link to the pin in the description, so if you guys want to give it a shot, go ahead. I'm gonna go with this is not one of my more successful endeavors, but that happens sometimes. And yeah, that's what I've got for you today. holds it. Sorry, this is a little rough, but that's what I've got. So, if you liked this video, go ahead and give me a big old thumbs up. And subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And make sure that you hit the bell button. Make sure you hit that bell button, because if you don't, you won't know when I post videos. Which is usually Tuesday mornings, but not always. You never know. You gotta hit the bell button, otherwise you won't know. But, yeah, that's it for me today. I hope you guys have a great rest of your week, and with a little bit of luck, next week's video is gonna be just the tiniest bit more interesting. So.